You've known now Judge Lester for 35 years, I guess. So what can you tell us about him?
Great person, great judge. We actually graduated from law school with each other. We're good friends in law school and been good friends throughout. He's a wonderful man. He's a great father. I've been married to Dorothy Sedgwick for 29 years. Dorothy is an experienced prosecutor in Orange County, the adjoining county from Seminole County, where he sits as a judge. Dorothy was a homicide prosecutor for many, many years. He has got a great demeanor, doesn't miss a trick, lots of common sense, a legal scholar on top of it. So he's really an excellent judge. I mean, his brain is as good as anybody I know. He's the kind of guy that can literally name the capital of every country in the world. He's not going to let anything get by, and he's going to give both sides an absolute fair hearing whenever required, and he'll give an absolute fair trial throughout this matter.
And Paul Callan, you've been exploring this judge's past. What does it tell you about how he'll handle the case, what he'll do?
Some interesting things. His daughter, who's a lawyer, was asked, does your dad agonize about making decisions being a judge? You would think, you know, when you have to sentence somebody in a murder case, you'd be up all night deciding on what the sentence is. His response to her was, it's easy. All you have to do is apply the law. So I think what that says to me about this case is he's not going to be agonizing about public sentiment or how the Martin family is going to react or the Zimmerman family is going to react. I think he's going to look at the facts and apply the law, and whichever side wins is going to win. That's my read on it,
a
non-emotional guy.
That sounds like what the country wants, to get to the truth and take out the passion and emotion, which is so...
Exactly.
I mean, everyone has a feeling about this case.
It's what a judge is supposed to do. He's made some controversial decisions. I found one schizophrenic woman who murdered her father and her mother, found not guilty by reason of insanity, and years later, a decade later, they wanted her to be released from jail because she appeared to be okay mentally. He ordered her release. He said that the law allows it, I'm going to order her release. That couldn't have been a very popular decision. So I think he's a judge who just applies the law. So if the law is on the Martins will win. If it's on the side of the Zimmermans will win, and that's how the system's supposed to work.